Hello guys and girls, this is RO7 here and you're watching a basic guide tutorial about stats and attributes in Dota 2. First of all, you should know that everything what you do in Dota 2 is actually part of math and it's per calculating on easier or harder way. Movement speed, attack range, amount of damage you deal and other are numbers which we are calling them stats. Stats can be increased by buying items, but let's talk about that later. In Dota 2 there are 10 stats and 3 attributes and we will go through all of them, so don't worry, sounds scary on first sight, but by playing more and more games you will gain experience and proper knowledge about how and most important when to increase them. First of all, you should notice huge bars at the lower mid part of screen. Green one will show you your health and health regeneration and blue one your mana and mana regeneration. Your health is actually amount of damage you can take. Second number will show your maximum amount of health and first number is representing your health at any given moment and that one can't exceed your maximum health. On right side of your health bar you can see number which shows you how fast and how much your health is regenerating per second. You can increase your health regeneration by purchasing some of the items. Down below under health bar you can see your mana. Mana is number just as your health. Second number show your maximum amount of mana and first one mana at any given moment. Same as in health bar, number at the end of mana bar shows your mana regeneration, which means how fast your mana is generating. Your mana will be used for casting your abilities or using some of your items, which is the reason why you always want more and more mana with bigger amount of regeneration. Those are 4 stats and the rest of them are placed in 2 categories. We have utility and combat stats. Let's go first. Movement speed. On first sight, that huge number isn't going to mean too much for you, but it's really important because it shows you how fast your hero can move. Average movement speed at the beginning of any game is around 300, more precisely it's from 280 to 320. Movement speed isn't random number, so every hero have his standard beginning movement speed. For increasing your movement speed, you're buying boots, but there are a couple items which improve your movement speed by percentage as well. Attack range is second utility stat and show you how far your hero can strike. Attack range cannot be increased by any item, so it's important to check every enemy hero to be sure that you can lane safely and to know what you can expect. Actually, there is only one hero which attack range can be increased and it's Sniper. Not by buying items, it's by leveling his passive ability. Rest of our stats are combat stats. Attack damage show you amount of damage which you can deal on enemy heroes, units or towers. Number under this icon show you your average damage, which means that if you have damage 60 to 17, your average damage which you can deal by one strike is 65. It's obvious, right? You can increase your attack damage by buying some of the items. If item gives you plus 10 damage, that means that your average damage will be increased by 10. So if your average attack damage is 65, by purchasing that item you will have 75 damage. Attack speed show you how fast your hero can strike. The higher attack speed you have means that you will make more attacks in same amount of time. When your attack speed is increased by percent, you will attack that percent more at the same amount of time. Let's give an example. If you have your attack speed increased by 100%, that means that you will strike twice at same time period. There are no difference in percentage and value when attack speed come in question. For example, Beastmaster's ability Inner Beast, which is passive, increase your attack speed by 18. Not percentage, only 80, but it means that is increased by 80%. Game tried to trick you and a lot of new players think wrong about that. So one more time, there is no difference between percentage and value when we are talking about attack speed. Although, you may notice that in some fights your attack speed is going down, that is because some of the spells actually reduce your attack speed. So if you have 115 and someone actually casts a spell which reduces your attack speed by 15, just an example, at that moment you will have 100 attack speed. Amount of time in which your attack speed is reduced depends on that particular spell and his duration. Now you have defensive stats. First of all, let's talk about armor. Armor reduces amount of physical damage you will take. That means that the higher armor you have, your enemies will make less damage on your hero. You need to have in mind that most of abilities makes magical damage, but there are actually a couple of them which make physical. All physical damage you take, it's reduced by a certain percent depends how much armor you have. So if you have 50% physical damage resistance, you will take only half of damage which enemy hero can deal at that particular moment. Formula to calculate how armor works is kinda complicated, so for more information about that you can check link in the description. If you really need to explain in simple terms, let's say that at the beginning each point of your armor gives you around 5.5% of physical damage resistance, but with increasing your armor until 20 points, every point will give you only around 2.5%. Damn that armor! Unfortunately, it can be more complicated because some of items actually reduce your armor. So if you have armor under 0, for example minus 1, you will take more damage than if you had no armor at all. Magical damage resistance is pretty much same as physical damage resistance. If you have a lot of nukes in enemy team, this is exactly what you want to increase, but we will talk about that in upcoming guides. Simply, if you have 50% magical damage resistance, that means that you will take only 50% from enemy magical damage. You have only 3 items in whole game which increase your magical damage resistance, and you are allowed to have only one of them. If you have more than one, game will choose only one and magic resistance doesn't earn from all of them. Attributes. Let's talk about attributes. Attributes doesn't do anything special for your hero, but every attribute gives you 2 base stats. Every hero in game have his primary attribute, you need to have that on mind. Every point in strange gives you more health and health regeneration, that means that you have more chances for survivability. Every point in agility give you more attack speed and increase your armor by 1, that means that your auto attack will get better, and also you will take less damage from other auto attacks. Every point in intelligence increase your mana and mana regeneration, which means that you will be allowed to cast your abilities more. Thank you for watching this guide, guys. Hopefully I helped, and if you found this content helpful or enjoyable, please like and subscribe. I would like to get any feedback, any critic, or maybe some new suggestions. This is Aru7 here, and I am going out.